Hi, my name is Ruby. I'm 9 years old, and I go to Merrimack Community Charter School. How can milk make so many different products?
My name is Scott Rankin. I'm a professor and chair of the food science department. Milk for mammals, right, is the sole source of sustenance and growth, nutrition-wise, for babies, infants, and so forth. And milk is the only food designed really to sustain life. You can drink just milk, as a young infant, and grow. You have to think that, well, milk must be very complex, and it is very complex. Eons ago, when humans started to domesticate mammals, they began to realize that the mammals made a lot more milk than was just needed for growing the babies of the animal. And so they had surplus milk, and they started to take different approaches to preserving it. Because the main component of milk is lactose, if you just let milk sit there, all that lactose will start to ferment, and the acid will develop, and you start going down the path of yogurt, start going down the path of cheese. If you take that yogurt and add a lot of salt to it, which is another means of preserving milk, well, again, it starts looking more like cheese, like things like cheddar and mozzarella and Parmesan cheese. Another means of preserving milk would be to freeze it. That's probably the predecessor of ice cream, and as a means of preserving milk. Good quality milk is very bland in flavor, so I think it took on a lot of, it was a vehicle for delivering a lot of different flavors. So if you had pepper or strawberries or any kind of flavor, milk worked with a lot of those flavors and kind of made it more, little variation to the diet, I think, was positive. And there are a lot of animals that we harvest milk from. Buy milk at the supermarket, it's cow's milk most likely, but there are a variety of other lactating animals that receive milk from, and they all have different characteristics, slight differences in their characteristics and chemistry and their complexity. So goat's milk has certain flavor and functional color characteristics, so sheep's milk's different yet, horse's milk, yak's milk, they all have unique characteristics that really drove unique products. So when we think about mozzarella, we think about pizza cheese and things like that, but really the start of mozzarella was because there's a region in Italy that supported water buffalo because of its ability to grow in that particular areas and regions in Italy that where cows could not thrive, but water buffalo could, and so they took the milk, and hence, out of that process, mozzarella was born.